In Bristol Bay, Alaska, for a few weeks every summer, an average of 38 million sockeye salmon emerge from the Pacific. This consistently large return defines the communities of the region and has been commercially harvested since the late 1800s. Today, the fishery is the highest value salmon fishery in North America. Effective management is crucial to the conservation of this highly exploited species. Management biologists make hour-by-hour decisions on when and where the fleet can fish, based on numerous sources of biological information. One of these sources is molecular genetic data that are used to determine which populations of inbound sockeye are most abundant. The data are used in real time to give a sneak preview of where sampled fish are headed. This helps managers target abundant populations and shift effort away from more limited populations. The process starts with the creation of a baseline. Geneticists sample spawning fish from populations representing the 9 distinct stocks of the bay. These fish are genotyped in the lab for select genetic markers that can be compared against the incoming sockeye. The Port Muller test fishery occurs down the Alaska Peninsula, along a transect between Port Muller and Cape Newenham, where the sockeye are roughly a week from reaching the fishery. A small appendage called the axillary process is clipped from the salmon and sped to anchorage. Upon arrival at the lab, the tissue sample undergoes an abstract transformation from tissue to liquid to letters to numbers as fast as possible. The samples are first built into the database, where the information linked to each fish is stored and tracked. The bulk of the sample is saved for quality control and future use, and the rest is used for DNA extraction. Before being genotyped, the DNA must first be isolated. A series of enzymes and digests remove unwanted tissue so that the purified DNA is available for analysis. Genotyping is a process that characterizes the DNA of each fish for reference genetic markers, providing signals that can be used to compare the DNA to the baseline data set and determine the genetic stock of origin for the fish. A liquid handling robot adds chemicals and DNA to a microfluidic chip where over 9,000 reactions take place, each one specific to a different genetic marker and fish. The DNA then undergoes a process called PCR, polymerase chain reaction, that makes millions of copies of each genetic marker. The amplified DNA is run through another machine that scans and scores the genotypes, providing the raw data to compare against the baseline. The tissue has now been transformed into letters. The final step of the process is the statistical analysis that converts the letters into numbers. Estimates of the relative abundance of fish from each of the major stocks currently swimming towards Bristol Bay. Fishery managers receive the stock composition estimates while the fish are still several days from arrival to the fishing grounds, and this information is factored into management decisions. Through this process, the fleet and economies benefit with increased catches, while the risk of overharvesting less abundant stocks is minimized. More and more Alaskan fisheries are using these genetic techniques, helping to protect the long-term sustainability of our resources for the well-being of the people of Alaska.